Well, hello, church. Hope this finds you well. It's a home fellowship group weekend, and so I wanted to give a preview of our topic for you this weekend. Now, if you're not a part of a home fellowship group and you want to jump into one, you can do that. All of our groups meet directly after church on Sunday morning. So even if this is your first time here, or maybe this is the first time going to a group, you can come find me or any other greeter or leader at church, and we can get you plugged into a group. Now, the topic that we're going to look at this week is the fruits of the Spirit. But I want to put that in context to our series. Our series is Life Together. We're looking at how our life in Christ affects and impacts those around us, what it looks like to live in the community of saints. And there's a phrase that I use in the lesson, and I want to bring it up now, maybe get you thinking about it, mulling over it. Maybe you can get in your discussion and say, I disagree with it, but whatever. Here's the phrase. The thing that we struggle with as Christians is to be theological narcissists. And here's what I mean by that. When we approach Scripture, we approach it more often than not thinking about how does this impact me? How does this affect me? We read our situations into it, our struggles into it, us into it. We're narcissistic in that way. But Scripture was never designed to be read as theological narcissist. It was given to everyone. And I think the fruits of the Spirit are a great illustration of us wrongly applying them first. Normally, when I approach the fruits of the Spirit, and so I'm just as guilty of it as the next guy, I think of it of how can I have more love? How can I possess more peace? How can I practice more patience? How can I be better person, feel better, experience more joy? How can I be a better person because of the fruits of the Spirit? But what we're going to see as we look at Galatians 5, that's our scripture passage that we're going to be digging into, is that the fruits of the Spirit were given so that we might, yes, stay away from sin, but to impact those around us. So as you're thinking about this discussion, as you're planning for a fellowship group, just start thinking about this. How does love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, self-control, I think I have all of them, maybe not. How do those fruits of the Spirit not first impact you, but impact your brother, sister, neighbor, fellow believer in the body of Christ? How can we first approach that text thinking, how am I going to bless the person that I'm living life with before how is that going to bless my life? Hope that that's an encouragement to you. I hope that that gets your wheels turning, and we'll see you on Sunday.